Dear students, having discussed what is unit roots, we now discuss how to detect whether there is unit root in a series. That is, whether a stochastic process, a time series, is non-stationary or not. Now, there are so many unit test procedures available in the literature. We start with the most widely used unit root test procedure, namely the Dickey-Fuller test. Known as DF tests. This Dickey-Fuller test is available in three forms, depending on whether we are considering a pure random walk, a random walk with drift, random walk with drift and a deterministic drift. We start with the example of the pure random walk. The test statistics is known as tau hat. You read it as tau hat test. To understand this test, consider the equation of a pure random walk. Phi 1 y t minus 1 plus epsilon t is equal to 1 to t, and epsilon t is assumed to be iid with the zero mean and variance sigma squared, identically and independently distributed. Normality of epsilon t is not required for the validity of Dickey-Fuller test. We know that for the validity of t-test, f, chi-square, etc., validity of the stochastic error term, normality of the stochastic error term is required. But here, normality is not required. The requirement is identically and independently distributed. Then, yt minus yt minus 1 is equal to phi 1 yt minus 1 minus yt minus 1 plus epsilon t, or delta yt is equal to gamma yt minus 1 plus epsilon t, where gamma is equal to phi 1 minus 1. Gamma is equal to phi 1 minus 1. Now, if phi 1 is equal to 1, gamma is equal to 0. Gamma is equal to 0. That means there is a unit root. If phi 1 is equal to 1, gamma is equal to 0. There is a unit root. If phi 1 is less than 1, phi 1 is less than 1, gamma is less than 0, negative, then the process is stationary. Now, we test the hypothesis that H0, gamma is equal to 0. H0, gamma is equal to 0. H0, gamma is equal to 0 means our null hypothesis is that the process is non-stationary. It is tested against H1. The process is stationary. Now, a question automatically arises is, why our test is not H0, the process is stationary? A process is stationary if the absolute value of phi 1 is less than 1. That means if our h0 is the process is stationary, we assume that phi 1 is between minus 1 and plus 1. But we know that such a null hypothesis cannot be handled in the classical linear regression framework, because in the classical linear regression, in the classical hypothesis testing procedure, the value of the parameter is specified under h0. So here the value is between minus 1 and plus 1, and plus 1 theoretically, so that such a null hypothesis cannot be tested. But the null hypothesis that the process is non-stationary can be tested, because only a single value is specified here. Phi 1 is equal to 1, gamma is equal to 0, the process is non-stationary. So h 0, gamma is 0. So a test statistics to test such a hypothesis is known as Tohat test statistics. It is not the same as T. Test statistics Tohat is not a T distribution. Stated differently, the test statistics Tohat will not have the standard T distribution. So it is inappropriate to consult a T table to find out the critical values. The critical values, depending on the sample size, are tabulated by Dickey and Fuller. In some statistics, some values are given in the books of econometrics. Otherwise, computer will give you the critical values of Tohat for 1%, 5%, 10%, etc. for different sample sizes. That is not a concern for you. So these critical values obtained by simulation and tabulated by Dickey and Fuller depends on H0 and H1. H0 is straightforward, and H0 is that the process is non-stationary. Now, what is H1? We can give H1 in two ways. H0, gamma is equal to 0, process is non-stationary. If the null hypothesis is accepted, the process is non-stationary. If it is rejected, it is stationary. Then H1 can be given as gamma not equal to 0. Now, gamma not equal to 0 means gamma can be greater than or less than 0. That means it can be positive or negative. Then, now consider this gamma greater than 0. Gamma greater than 0 means phi 1 is greater than 1. Phi 1 is greater than 1 means, again, the process is not stationary. Theoretically, such a possibility is very rare. But gamma greater than 0, that is, gamma is positive, means it is not stationary. But what we require is, if the null hypothesis of non-stationary is rejected, we must have a stationary series. Stationary series if gamma is less than 0, that is, phi 1 is less than 1. So the alternative hypothesis is gamma is less than 0. That is, we have an alternative hypothesis, gamma less than 0. Gamma greater than 0 is not considered, or gamma not equal to 0 is not considered. The reason is, we can take a one-sided test, and if we can take a one-sided test against a two-sided test, it will increase the power of the test statistics. So H1 is gamma is equal to 0. Gamma 0 means phi 1 is equal to 1. H1 is gamma less than 0, that means phi 1 is less than 1. So the h 0 is the process is non-stationary, h 1 is the process is stationary. The test statistics is tau hat, and as the null hypothesis is 0, the tau hat can be written as equal to gamma hat divided by standard error of gamma hat, minus 0 here. So, gamma hat by standard error of gamma hat. Since the alternative hypothesis is left, is consistent with a left tail test, critical values are negative. With the sample values more negative than critical, resulting in the rejection of H0. So, critical values are negative and sample values more negative than critical, leading to rejection of the null hypothesis in favor of non-rejection. Whereas if the sample values are less negative than critical values, we accept H0. And as an example, suppose that for t is equal to 100, the 1% critical value, 5% critical value, -2.6, -1.9. Suppose that the obtained tau hat is equal to -2.10. So at a 5% significant level, the sample value is more negative than critical value, so H0 is rejected. That means the process is stationary. But at 1%, we will conclude that as it is less negative than critical values, H0 is accepted. So for a usual 5% significance level, we will say that the process is stationary, because it is more critical than, more negative than critical. So this process is stationary. H0 is rejected in favor of H1. So this is the first test, tau hat test. Now let us see the second test. The second test is tau hat mu test. Tau hat mu test. Now, a general principle in constructing test statistics to distinguish between H0 and H1 is that the maintained regression include both as special cases, so that either H0 or H1 could be discovered from the sample data. Now, the maintained regression for tau hat test is delta yt is equal to gamma yt minus 1 plus epsilon t, which ness gamma is equal to 0 and gamma is less than 0. Gamma less than 0. But this test statistics is quite restrictive in the sense that both under, so H0 gamma is equal to 0, H1 gamma is less than 0. This test statistics is highly restrictive in the sense that both under H0 and H1, YT has a zero mean. Remember this, for the pure random walk, we have shown that if I1 is equal to 1 or less than 1, the process has zero mean. But this assumption is not terrible, especially under H1, a stationary process frequently crosses the mean axis. The mean axis. Remember this? In this case, 0, under H0, if a null hypothesis is rejected, the stationary around 0, otherwise it has a wandering like this. This is the case. But suppose that you have a process which is stationary, but it crosses a mean axis which is not equal to 0. Suppose you have a process like this. It is, the value of mean is here. The process crosses like this. It is stationary around a mean which is not equal to 0. That is the case of the second case. Phi 1 less than 1, an intercept mu was added. But then mean is equal to mu minus 1, mu by 1 minus phi 1. That is the second case, remember that. So if you have, and if the null hypothesis is rejected, you have a process with the, it is exhibiting a tendency like this. Like this. Now, that means if you observe a series which crosses the mean axis frequently, this is not the correct testing procedure. So, to take account of this possibility, we modify this model as yt is equal to mu plus phi 1 yt minus 1 plus epsilon t, and delta yt is equal to mu plus gamma yt minus 1 plus epsilon t, where gamma is equal to phi 1 minus 1. As in the first case, h 0, gamma is equal to 0, h 1, gamma is less than 0. Now, a mu is added to tau hat to specify that this is a different model, or this is a model with an intercept. And critical values for this test is different from this test. So this will also be available in the softwares, so you need not worry about this also. Now, the test statistics in this case is referred to as tau hat mu. And for as an example, for t is equal to 50, tau hat mu 1%, 5%, 1% is given as minus 3.58, minus 2.93. Now suppose that from the sample you get a value equal to minus 3, then you conclude that at a 5% level, you cannot reject H0. So, the process is stationary. Whereas, at 1%, you accept the H0. That is, the process is non-stationary. At 5%, it is stationary. 1%, it is non-stationary. So if we take 5% as the critical value, we conclude that H0 is rejected, the process is stationary, because minus 3 is greater than minus 2.93 in absolute terms. So we reject H0 and conclude that the process is stationary. So if you have a process which has a mean which is not equal to 0, the process is mu something, some not equal to 0, then you adopt tau hat mu as the test statistics. Now, we consider the third variant, namely Tow hat beat. Suppose that you have a series. The series exhibits an upward trend like this. Upward trend like this. And this is the typical pattern of most of the time series. And the purpose of unit root test is to determine whether a series is consistent with I1 process so that it has a stochastic trend, or whether it is I0 so that it has a deterministic trend. Deterministic trend versus stochastic trend. The data shows an upward trend. The question is whether it is deterministic or stochastic. If it is deterministic, it is I0. If it is stochastic, it is I1. So if the series exhibits a trend-like behavior, then tow hat statistics or tow hat mu cannot be applied, because in the first case, the series will not exhibit any trends. In the second case, if H0 is accepted, the process exhibits trends. But if it is rejected, the process is stationary, then it fluctuates around a constant mean. So it has no power to exhibit a trend. So if a series exhibits a trend-like behavior, then we cannot use either the first or the second test. So to take into account such a possibility, we modify the model as yt is equal to mu plus phi 1 yt minus 1 plus beta t plus epsilon t, with the delta yt is equal to mu plus gamma yt minus 1 plus beta t plus epsilon t, gamma is equal to phi 1 minus 1, and H0, gamma is equal to 0 versus H1, gamma is less than 0. Now the test statistics is tow hat beta to specify the fact that it is a model with the trend beta. Now the testing procedure is same. If H0 is accepted, the process is non-stationary. Otherwise, it is stationary. So the point is, Dickey-Fuller test is available in three forms: tow hat, tow hat mu, tow hat beta. If your series exhibits an upward trend, as I told you earlier, when you deal with the time series data, you must first plot it. As Granger has once suggested, it's a very famous quotation, if one is not plotting his data, he is asking for trouble. If one is not plotting his data, he is asking for trouble. So if you are using time series data, you must plot it. And if you observe a behavior like this, then the model is this. But if no tendency, an upward tendency is there, say the process is something like this, then the model is this. But if the process has zero mean, the first model can be used. But in most cases, first model is not usable, second and third. Whether the process exhibits a trend, in this case, if H0 is accepted, there is stochastic trends. If rejected, deterministic trends. Both under H0 and H1, the maintained regression model can be discovered. Or we will say the model nests H0 and H1 as special cases, so that with the data, either H0 or H1 can be detected. So this is the three versions of Dickey-Fuller test. And these three versions depends on whether we are considering the three different models. And always remember pure random walk with the drift, random walk with the drift and deterministic trends. Then only these test statistics will be clear to you. But softwares will give you estimates of all this. That is not a problem. The only thing is you will be able to identify the correct process that will give you correct results. If your process has no trends, and if you apply this, you will get the misleading results. If you have a process has trends, if you apply this for the first, again, you will get a misleading results. But Dickey Fuller test is not applied like this. It is what we do is augmented Dickey Fuller test that we will consider in the next class.